So before starting our lecture, we have to just revise the previous lectures. So just to memorize the previous formulas for the derivation of a certain system. So what is the formula for acceleration of bodies attached to a string passing over the frictionless pulley? We have already discussed, but you have to just memorize it and just revise that formulas. What is the formula for finding the tension? One was the formula for finding the acceleration, and other was the formula for finding the tension of that particular system. And what is the relation between force and momentum? At the end of the previous lecture, we have also discussed that, what is the relation between force and momentum. So moving toward our lecture, law of conservation of momentum. First, what is momentum? Momentum of a system actually depends on mass and velocity of the bodies, right? Mass and velocity of the body, because we have already derived that P is equal to mv. So over here, mass and velocity. But what is the system? We use a term system. So at this stage, you have to make sure, and you should have a clear idea about the system, that what will be the system and the rest of the discussion. So system is a group of bodies within certain boundaries. Group of bodies and certain boundaries. So what is everyone know that what will be the group of bodies, but what about the boundaries? These boundary may not be the physical boundary. It may be your ideal boundaries. For example, we have let's say a ball. This is a ball, right? And if you want to discuss its properties, or you can say its motion, so it is not necessary that you have to place this ball inside a box. This is not necessary. This outside box should be considered ideally. That imagine this is a ball within the box, but it is not necessary that you should have to put this ball inside the box and then discuss its properties, or you can say its motion, right? So this is not necessary. Example of physical boundaries, for example, if I want to discuss the moment or physical situation of the students inside the class, so obviously the class have physical boundaries. So over here, boundaries are physical one, if you consider the students in the class. But if you consider the ball in the ground, so it has no physical boundaries. So it means that boundaries may be physical one or ideal one, that you have to just consider the boundaries. Now, what is the law of conservation of momentum? So, law of conservation of momentum states that the momentum of an isolated system of two or more than two interacting bodies remains constant. Two or more than two interacting bodies will remain constant, right? Moving toward the explanation, first, what is isolated system? Over here, there are certain terms. First one is isolated system. So isolated system is a group of interacting bodies. System interacting bodies means the system, right? How it will be isolated? So on which no external, we will call the system to be isolated when no external force acting on the system. Or you can say no unbalanced force acting on the system, right? So moving toward the formula, we have already derived the relation between momentum and force. So this was the relation in the previous lecture, that change in momentum per unit time is known as force, rate of change of momentum, or you can say delta p divided by delta t is equal to force, right? So this was the relation for finding the relation between force and momentum. So moving forward, since the system is isolated, remember, isolated system, the momentum of an isolated system, this is isolated system, right? In this law we consider only the isolated system, and we discussed that isolated system is the system in which there is no unbalanced or no external or no unbalanced force. So what is that unbalanced force? That unbalanced force will be this one. So this law states that when this unbalanced force is not present for the system or on the system, so momentum will be conserved, or momentum will be same before and after the occurrence of certain activities. So we put zero over here because the system is isolated. And so force is zero. We put force equal to zero by cross multiplication. If we place one over here, so PF minus PI will be multiplied with one, and T will be multiplied with 0, so it will comes out to be PF minus PI is equal to 0. Now rearranging this, PI can be shifted toward this, so it will become plus. So PF is equal to PI. A little explanation, what is PF? So PF is the final momentum, right? And what is PI? Initial momentum. This is the PI, the initial momentum. So what does it mean? It means that the initial and final momentum are equal for isolated system. So that is why law of conservation of momentum says that if no external force acting on the body, no external force is acting on a body, so initial momentum and final momentum will be same or equal. A little explanation, consider the example of air-filled balloon. Let's say we have this balloon which is filled with the air, and over here there is no physical boundary, right? So I just consider the boundary for this system, so that we can discuss this system in isolated form. Now what happens if we release air from the balloon? Let's say the air is moving outward from the balloon, right? Now what was the initial condition? Initially the air was inside the balloon, right? So the system was balanced. The momentum were P, which is I, initial momentum were zero, right? Now, if we release the air, we allow the air to move away from the, move outside from the balloon. So the air will move like this, right? In this direction. So the momentum of air, now after the releasing, Pi were zero, right? Now after the releasing, the momentum of air is in this direction, right? Now in order to balance this, what will be the momentum of this balloon? It must be in opposite direction. So after the releasing of air, after the air is allowed, so the momentum of air is in this direction and the momentum of balloon is in opposite direction. So both these also cancel out each other, and as a result the final momentum, which is Pf, is also zero. So Pi and Pf is equal to zero, even though it has also some value. Let's say this is 10. So let's say this is 10 and this is, the balloon will be minus 10. So when we add this, this total will give us the final momentum Pf, and this is zero. So initial and final momentum is are equal. Now moving forward, the same, you can also read these bullets, but the explanation is already discussed with you. We can also take the example of a rocket. The picture is also present in your book. So what happens in case of rockets? Let's say this is a type of rocket. So gases are leaving the rocket. So initially when the rocket were not fired, so rocket were at rest. Now if you when the rocket is fired, so the gases will move downward, right? So initial momentum were zero. What about the final? So if we look at the final momentum, so the gases are moving downward. And so let's say this is 20. Let's say the momentum of this air is, or this gases are 20. So what will be the momentum of this? It will be minus 20. Equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. So when we add this, so final Pf will be also be equal to zero. So initial momentum and final momentum is equal, are equal. So this is the law of conservation of momentum. Now consider another example, collision of two bodies, and applying the law of conservation of momentum to discuss what will be the initial and final velocity of the system. So moving forward, let's say we have two bodies which has mass m1 and m2 in the figure A, this one. Both bodies are moving in, moving toward right, right? But remember, this has greater velocity and mass 2 have lower velocity. That is why mass 1 will move toward the mass 2 and it will approach to mass 2. So what will be the initial momentum of mass 1? It will be m1 u1, because the initial velocity is u, it is denoted with u. What will be the initial momentum of second? So it will be m2 u2. What will be the total initial momentum of the system? This is the system. If we consider this total as a system, so you have to just consider the boundary for the system also. So if I consider a boundary, so the total momentum of this system, which is the combination of two masses, is m1 u1 plus m2 u2, right? After the collision, mass m1 hits m2 with some force, right? Because mass m1 is moving at greater velocity, so obviously it will reach m2, right? So collision will happen over here. What happens after collision? If you can also imagine two cars on the roads, let's say this is a truck which is moving slowly and this is a car. So when a car is moving at somewhat greater velocity and whenever it reaches their truck, so after collision car will slows down, right? And truck will increase its velocity a little bit, right? So truck will increase its velocity. So now what will be the final momentum of the bodies? Final momentum of mass m1 will be this one, because velocity will be changed, the m1 velocity will be decreased, and final momentum of m2, since velocity will be changed because the velocity of the second body will increase, right? So obviously both velocities will be changed, and the total final momentum of this particular system, this is also a system, the same system which is over here, so it will be m1 v1 plus m2 v2. Now what about the law of conservation of momentum? According to the law of conservation of momentum, this total momentum, this total momentum and this total momentum, which is before and after the collision, will be equal. So this is the expression for the law of conservation of momentum when two bodies are colliding with each other and are in the same direction. If they were in the opposite direction, so it, the system will be a little different, right? Now let's consider another system of gun and bullet. So before firing the gun, both the bullet and gun, let's say this is let's say a gun, right? And let's say this is a bullet which is initially inside the gun. Right? Now before the firing of bullet, the gun and bullet were at rest. So initial momentum PI is zero. Right? Now when the bullet is fired, so it will be, let's say it will be over here, so the bullet will move in the forward direction, right? Now this bullet will have some momentum, right? This bullet will have some momentum. Let's say the mass of bullet is small m and the mass of gun is capital M. So what will be the momentum of the bullet? Momentum of the bullet will be small m and velocity of the bullet. And what will be the momentum of the gun? Let's say I denote this momentum with small g also. So it will be capital M, and let's say this is capital V, right? So the momentum of the bullet is small v small m, and the momentum of the gun is capital M and capital V, right? So the initial and final momentum of the system will be equal according to the law of conservation of momentum, right? So I just erase this figure. to make it clear. Now, the total momentum of the gun and the bullet after the gun is fired will be this one, right? Law of conservation of momentum, again we can apply the law of conservation of momentum. So initial momentum and final momentum will be same for the total system, not for the gun or for the bullet, for the total system. So initial momentum was zero and final momentum is this one, right? Just rearrange this. So can I shift this small m and v to the right? So it will be minus one, right? Now putting the rearranging or dividing by capital M. So what is v? This v, this v actually denote the velocity of recoil. What is the velocity of recoil? It is the jerk when gun is fired. So it will be happen to the gun, right? To the gun. So this is that velocity with which the gun will be recoiled. The gun will push back the man, or you can say the instrument or the device, to the back in order to conserve the momentum, right? Similar, we can also use this equations for rockets and jet engines and for other machines also. Now let's solve an example on this derived equation. So consider a bullet of mass 20 gram is fired with a velocity of 100 meter per second, and the mass of the gun is 5 kg, right? So we have the given data. Small m is the mass of the bullet, small v is the velocity of the bullet, capital M is the velocity of the mass of gun, and capital V is the velocity of the gun. So we have to find the recoil velocity, find the recoil velocity of the gun. So again, law of conservation of momentum, capital M V plus small m V is equal to zero. Just putting the values, we have the value of capital M, small m and small v. So we can find the capital V and it will be minus 0.4 meter. What does it mean? What is mean by minus sign over here? What is mean by this negative sign? So this negative sign indicates that if the velocity of the bullet is in this direction, so the gun will recoil in the opposite direction, right? So this was all about this lecture. If you have any question, so you can ask, and that's all from my side. Thank you.